our local government. We welcome you all to this march and would just call your attention to the fact that 50 years ago, we had an interracial shooting in Berea, and two people were killed. It was a presidential year, and George Wallace and the state's rights party was in Berea electioneering in September, and there ended up being a shootout after a confrontation, and a white and a black were dead on the road down there by the subway on 25 North. That's some of the thoughts that flood back to me whenever we have an anniversary like this. In part because my father was on the city council and ended up being one of the local representatives who served on a commission. It wasn't a human rights commission back then, but a commission to try to learn from that and do better going forward. And so with some of that starker and darker recollection, I would just like to make a few comments about Martin Luther King. I consider Martin Luther King to have been an American prophet in the Old Testament tradition who left as his legacy to Berea's local government, Berea College, our citizens, the continuing challenge to make our society equal, just, and diverse. In Dr. King's crusade for racial justice, he argued that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere, and challenged us to honor the promise of our heritage. He proclaimed that the real heroes of the South to be those disinherited children of God who, using tactics of nonviolence, sat down at lunch counters and thereby stood up for what is best in the American dream, and thereby carried our nation back to the great wells of democracy, which were dug deep by the founding fathers in the formulation of the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence. At the Lincoln Memorial, he spoke like the prophet Amos when he challenged American society to notice that its African American citizens were still sadly crippled by the manacles of segregation and the chains of discrimination, warned us to avoid the tranquilizing drug of gradualism, and argued that now was the time to make real the promise of democracy. Now was the time to rise from the dark and desolate valley of segregation to the sunlit path of racial justice. And now was the time to open the doors of opportunity to all of God's children. And now was the time to lift our nation from the quicksands of racial injustice to the solid rock of brotherhood. These were the words he used to describe our responsibility to do justice, love kindness, and to fashion a world where the dark clouds of racial prejudice have passed away and the deep fog of misunderstanding has lifted from our fear-drenched communities, allowing the radiant stars of love and brotherhood to shine over our great nation. But for us in Berea and at Berea College, Dr. King's prophetic message was not necessarily new, because we were familiar with another prophet who had waged a similar campaign before the Civil War against slavery and the fugitive slave law, and who had offered our nation, after that bloody Civil War, an alternative social model to Jim Crow segregation, a model based upon God's impartial love, access to education, and an opportunity to own land. Reverend John Fee, like Dr. King, had recognized that we are all one people before God and that discrimination is unjust. to us. To honor their legacies, we must ensure that their nonviolent struggles for justice go on, that their constant demands for equality endure, and that their dreams of achieving diversity never die. And ultimately, we must view these dreams in the changing light of modern circumstances and seek out and eradicate discrimination and injustice wherever it exists today. This is the dual legacy of Dr. King and Reverend Fee, and the challenge that it places on local government, Berea College, and citizens today.